The Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge under commanding General Yohanna presents the Big 5-0. The 50th annual Lord's Passover, Saturday, April 20th at sundown.
But I'm here to tell you one thing. Whatsoever life you got, you better go out, man, and do the will of the Most High like it has never been done before. And say the next thing that's on your heart.
The 50th annual Lord's Passover, Saturday, April 20th at sundown. Shalom.
White man. Trump is talking about Mexicans bringing dope over the wall. That's a goddamn liar. U.S. military flying in both crack cocaine and anything else. The Iran-Contra scandal came from the U.S. military from all over North. So don't talk about no Mexican bringing something over our wall. A wall ain't gonna stop a goddamn thing as long as the white man is on the earth. The white man is the school shooter. Y'all heard about the Coast Guard that was massing up guns to go kill liberals? But now you wanna talk about black people violent and Hispanic people violent. The white man is the most violent beast on the earth. Look at Liam Neeson, that old Irish, old dead half-foot in a grave actor. He wanted to kill any black person because his slut of a woman said she was raped by a black man. Let me tell you something. Black man ain't got to rape no white woman. Black men don't got to rape no white woman. You white women want black men more than you want air to breathe. And I ain't lying about it. You're fantasizing about it. Half of y'all go to college in a different state just to have sex with a black man before you go marry your husband. Liam Neeson woman ain't never been raped by no white woman, by no black man. White women been lying about black men raping them for hundreds of years. Tulsa, Oklahoma, America dropped bombs and killed 3,000 black people because one white slut said a black man touched her in an elevator. Emmett Till was killed, murdered, lynched because some white slut lied and said he whistled at her. Rosewood, a white woman, was pouring on her husband when her husband came over. You know what she said? She said, nigga, a nigga did this to me. You white women lie about black men every goddamn day. And the white man is the goddamn devil the Bible speaks of. So this is February, Black History Month, right? Let me get you some black history. Hey, Ash, just look in my bag. You brought a book called American Apartheid. Medical Apartheid. How many of y'all know who J. Marion Sims is? Anybody knows who J. Marion Sims is? J. Marion Sims. Let me get some volume on this, please. Anybody know who J. Marion Sims is? All you damn white people. All you send your little girls to the gynecologist, and then you talk about we the plague of society. If it wasn't for black women, you white women couldn't go to the OBGYN. And I'm going to pull out the history of it right now. It's a red and black covered book called Medical Apartheid. Come on, look for it real quick. I'm going to show you how they did experiments on black women to develop modern gynecology with absolutely no anesthetic. Go catch rice, you filthy African. Go catch some rice. Go swat some flies and catch some rice. Hold this here for me, brother. Hold this here for me. Can you put this back? Right, go make a fly cake, you filthy African. But let me hold this for you. Where's the book I just gave you? Please. I'm going to show you what the white man is about. They ain't going to teach you this in for Black History Month. They ain't going to teach you none of that for Black History Month, right? They ain't going to teach you none of that. Give me right here. Hold on. You're going to start right here. This book is a book called Medical Apartheid. It gives you the history, the medical history of America using slaves. And America has used slaves for hundreds of years to run experiments. so that you can have your modern day medicine. You white devils got a day to pay, man. All you white devils, you have a day to pay. And I pray it comes quickly, that Christ comes and bathes the streets of America in your blood, because you're a vile, violent race of people. You are cruel, and you got no remorse. So God got to put you to death.
That's right.
Read from right where on, where's the underline. Let me tell you something. J. Marion Sims is a man who they call the father of modern gynecology. He had slaves, and what he would do is have them bring black women in, strain them, strap them down to a table, and he would take a damn knife and cut black women's vaginas open in the name of science to try to study the vagina. And you white women today, you benefit from our sisters. And you walk around like if you're the best on the earth. When you are a filthy goddamn cockroach.
That's right.
You're a river rat. You're a goddamn dog. You ain't a goddamn man. Let the Lord bathe the streets of America in your blood. You have put your foot on our necks for 400 years. Murdered us, lynched us, set us on fire. And now we're finding out you did experiments on us. No anesthesia. Cutting young girls open. I'm gonna read it for you. They said the slaves would stop working from the screams of the woman in the barnyard when this damn devil, J. Marion Sims, was cutting her open. But they ain't gonna tell you that for Black History Month. Half of y'all in your schools, they're having Wakanda Day. You see how a white man is? Selling you a movie for your goddamn history. When your history is American history. Without you, there would be no America. Read.
This innocent taboo can hardly defer more from the gruesome reality.
Start over.
This innocent taboo can hardly defer more from the gruesome reality in which each surgical scene was a violent struggle.
Right. Each what? Each surgical what?
Each surgical scene was a violent struggle.
Was a what?
Was a violent struggle.
This book is a history book of J. Marion Sims and some of his medical practices. And it said these surgeries on these black women were violent struggles. Violent struggles. Why is it violent struggles? Because you racist white pieces of trash devils. You know nothing about compassion for people. You would force your hand on everybody as long as you don't get caught. But a day is coming when a black man gonna cut your goddamn head off.
That's right.
Gonna cut your goddamn head off. You go look up the medical company called Pfizer. Pfizer owns a painting of J. Marion Sims in a barnyard with two other doctors and a black woman sitting on a table. And you would think that the surgeries was non-violent. This is the history. The surgeries was very much violent. Read.
Each surgical scene was a violent struggle between the slaves and the physicians.
Between what?
Between the slaves and the physicians.
Each surgical procedure was a violent struggle between slaves and physicians. I thought the white man was good. I thought he was great. They would drag our women out from their homes and cut them open for what? The sake of medicine? White man, you don't care nothing about medicine. You don't care nothing about technological advancements. You care about being cruel and evil as you could be. Read.
And each woman's body was a bloody battleground.
Each woman's... Stay up here.
Hey, you say a lot of us just want to get along. So after you done lynched us and killed us for 400 years, you want to get along with us now? Can I ask you a question? Because you make a valid point. You make a valid point. There it is. You know what the thing is? Guess what? And there comes, instead of Captain Save-A-Ho, you always got a sister to come in. Captain Save-A-Cracker. Or Sister Save-A-Cracker. Always, man. Hey, go ahead, brother.
Sellout Save Daddy. Big Daddy. Big Daddy. Could tell she destroyed head look like a damn dirty tennis ball. But you coming to save Big Daddy. When 200 years ago, Big Daddy would strap you to a table and cut your vagina open while you scream and shock the whole goddamn plantation. They said the slaves would all stop working when the black woman would scream from the barns. They said the blood flowed like it was an abattoir. And you coming to save this devil today? Listen, a day is coming. A day is coming, just like how the white man deal with his traitors, God is going to deal with his traitors too. Read.
And each woman's body was a bloody battleground.
Say it again.
And each woman's body was a bloody battleground.
Each woman's body was a bloody battleground at the hands of a white man, at the hands of white people, at the hands of America. Each black woman's body was a bloody battleground in the name of what? Medicine? Science? White man, why didn't you cut your own white woman open? Why didn't you cut your own daughters open? Why didn't you do that? But you decided to prey on our women. You decided to prey on us. While you done enslaved us and whipped the blood from our backs and light us on fire, you steal our women to cut them open to study organs while they're alive. And they don't teach you that in black history. Huh? They don't teach you that in black history. Right? Go to the gynecologist now. Huh? Read.
Each naked, unanesthetized slave woman had to be forcibly restrained.
Say it again.
Each naked, unanesthetized slave woman had to be forcibly restrained.
Each naked slave woman had to be forcibly restrained. While this doctor, this great Dr. J. Marion Sims, the father of modern gynecology, this medical hero, would cut them open. The white man is the devil, the Bible speaks of. Read.
By the other physicians, through her strength of agony, as Sims determinedly sliced.
Right? Through her shrieks of agony, as Sims determinedly sliced. Meaning he was determined. Meaning he came and he held her down and put that knife into her groin and cut her vagina open. Why they don't teach you that in school? Huh? Why they don't teach you that in school? But you got these white people walking around today like they so great and they so goddamn noble. When you're a race of monsters, man, you're a race of monsters and you need to be put in a cage. You need to be put in the grave or in a cage where you can't hurt nobody. Talking about gun control. We don't need that goddamn gun control. We need white man control. Put that on the ballot. You devils will kill with a goddamn fork with a butter knife. We don't need no gun control. You're the only out of control person on the earth. You goddamn terrorist. And thanks be to God, we don't need your damn justice system. You can keep all your damn judges. We're waiting on Christ to come back and drain the blood from your neck. And polish the streets with your blood. White DNA all over the goddamn place. You black people, you don't touch white people here on their head. You obey God's laws and Christ will cut their head off. And the remainder of them, you are going to be the slaves of the people your forefathers enslaved. And listen, and you Africans, you're going to be a slave too. You Chinese, you Japanese, all you heathen nations that come to America and live deliciously off the struggle of black people, guess what? When Christ returns, you're going to be a slave. When Christ returns, you're going to be a slave. You Chinese people, you like making wonton soup and fried rice? Listen, you better learn to make it good. When I order, I want 1,000 grains. Not one more, not one less. Or I'll cut your heads off. You better practice it right now. Right now. You better learn to be a slave to black people. You know why? Because you came over here and you benefit from the slavery of black people. You Chinese dead people should be ashamed of yourself. You're on the land that we bled and died, and you making millions, and you look down on black people. You Koreans beating up black women in stores. When if we didn't pick cotton and serve this devil, you Koreans would be in the rice marshes right now, poor as hell. But ain't no sweat. A day is coming. A day is coming. Read.
They searched her genitalia. Uh-huh. The other doctors who could fled when they could bear the horrific scenes.
Read that part again.
The other doctors who could fled when they could.
Hey, thank you, brother.
The other doctors who could fled when they could bear the horrific scenes no longer.
Listen, they said they would cut the black woman open and the scene would be so horrific, the white doctors who was holding her down would run out the damn barn because it was so horrific. And now today you got sisters going to have sex and marry white men. You should be ashamed of yourself, man. You laying down with some white devil when these devils done murdered your foremothers and cut them open for fun. So you want to tell me about you can love everybody? Nah, damn that, you cannot love everybody. You cannot love everybody. You think Donald Trump's daughter will go marry Bin Laden's son? That would be like a spit in the face. But you can understand that. But you can't understand when I tell Serena Williams she a goddamn traitor for raising that white devil seed in her womb. You don't understand that shit. Excuse me. You don't understand that. You don't understand that.
It's a lot. Go ahead. What you want?
And then fell to the woman to restrain one another.
And you know what these devils did? When those white, other white doctors could not stand the screams and the blood and they left, they commanded female slaves to go in there and hold that slave down so J. Marion Sims could further cut her womb open. Imagine you laying on a damn gurney. No anesthesia, no drugs, nothing. You held down and somebody cutting into your vagina or into your ovaries, slicing your fallopian tube open. You don't want to hear that though. You think it's too much. Well, swallow it down, nigga. It's Black History Month. Swallow it down. I'm sick and tired of you Uncle Tom niggas in D.C. thinking you just a dark-skinned white person. When you a nigga that's just like me, you need to feel the pain of your people and stop goddamn hiding. Read.
Betsy's voice has been silenced by history.
Say it again.
Betsy's voice has been silenced by history.
Betsy was the name of this slave who was featured in that picture of J. Marion Sims. It says her voice was silenced by history. You know why it was silenced? Because you white people don't want the world to know what you really did to black people. You proud, disgusting bastards. You devils. You want the world to look at you like you so great and you so honorable and you so noble and you so peaceful when you're a monster. You're a monster on the earth! Read!
But as one reads Sim's biographies and his own memoirs, a haughty, self-absorbed researcher emerges. A man who bought black women slaves and addicted them to morphine in order to perform dozens of... exquisitely painful, distressingly intimate vaginal surgery.
J. Marion Sims, after a while, he would go buy female slaves only and get morphine. You know why? Because the slaves before would scream so loud, they would shock the plantation. They would stop the work on the plantation. They would shock everybody. So he would go buy slaves just to operate on, hook them on morphine so he could cut them open. Say what? What'd you say? Oh, you're defending the white man? You defending him? I hear you, I hear you, whatever. I hear you, I hear you. Go down to Muriel Bowser's office and tell her that. Go down to Muriel.
Start selling out.
Right, when you stop selling out, I'll listen to you. You sellouts are just like snitches. Nobody likes snitches, right? You a snitch, you a rat. Well, listen, you niggas that choose white people over your own, you a snitch. You selling out, and we don't like sellouts up here. So go down to Muriel Bowser's office and tell her that.
The Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge under commanding General Yohana presents the Big 5-0, the 50th annual Lord's Passover, Saturday, April 20th at sundown.
But I'm here to tell you one thing. Whatsoever life you got, you better go out, man, and do the will of the Most High like it has never been done before. And say the next fucking life that's on your heart.
The 50th annual Lord's Passover, Saturday, April 20th at sundown. Shalom.